Welcome back, guys. This is Logan Paul predicts Jake Paul versus Ben Askren. Personally, I believe if it goes past the fourth round, it might be in Ben Askren's favor. But then again, when you look at the time period that Ben Askren he fights, it's 3 5-minute rounds, and championships are 5 5-minute rounds. But either way, this is going to be an 8-round fight. I'm not sure how many minutes it is, but it's very hard to keep your endurance when you've got that many rounds. And it might be small bursts, but it's only a limited amount of time that you get a breather with. So let's get into this.
Ben Askren, world-class wrestler, Olympic wrestler, one of the best in the world at wrestling.
Yep.
Not a striker.
He's just got to work on his striking.
This is the dude who got knocked out by Jorge Masvidal in 6 seconds.
Well, five seconds.
I need to know. I don't know. I don't care what you need to know.
He is called Ben Askren with the iron chin. Now, he did have one bad fuck up, and he got hit by a flying knee from Masvidal, which is never going to happen in a boxing match, I don't think, unless Jake is practicing being Liu Kang from fucking World Combat.
He was playing around with Masvidal.
But otherwise, Masvidal being the BMF, the leader of being a bad motherfucker. Supposedly, other than that, Ben has quite the chin, bro. He can take shots.
I was at his first fight in the UFC, and I was very excited.
I was with you.
Yep.
You lost $30,000 on fucking...
Yeah, Tyron Woodley.
Yeah. And he got fucking dropped on his head.
Got rocked.
On his head.
But then guess what he did?
He got up and finished the fucking fight.
And grabbed Robbie Lawler in some... Weird headlock and just squeeze for dear life, and the dude tapped out and Ben won. And I was
Can you pull the slam up? Mm-hmm. It is so nasty.
He got rocked.
Drop pile driven.
I was excited to watch him get into the UFC because he's got an interesting look.
He beats Cowboy Cerrone as well.
He's funny looking and funny when he speaks. He's just like, he's an entertainer. Like, you know, I was ready, and then damn, he was getting the shit kicked out of him. He got dropped, and then pulled the win out of his ass for his first win in the UFC, and then just has been riddled with losses ever since. And I don't know if he's still signed with the UFC. The Masvidal one was bad. Obviously, that was bad.
UFC also has a passive Bellator, but that was honestly one of the more exciting fights of that night. Probably the most exciting fight of that night. Yeah. And what we've seen from him so far leading in this Jake fight is more of that kind of showmanship. He unveiled this punching bag with Jake's face after the fall. The first thing, I'm trying to understand this striking from Askren. When I watch these videos of him punching, have you ever gotten into a fight against a apparition or a monster in your dream before? And when you throw punches, they go so slow and you can't...
Okay, so whenever Ben Askren punches, he doesn't really punch to land. He punches so that it can distract the person so that he can go for the takedown, which you obviously cannot do in a boxing match. So... the baseline is he's going to have to learn his striking, and he's going to have to learn how to get fast at it because Jake is pretty fast, even on his back foot. So there's
can't
that.
Make contact with the being the murderer. Every fucking time.
He's on drugs.
Both. But like, you know, you throw those overhand punches, you can't. And I watch Askren punching, and I can't understand, is he doing this as a joke? And obviously when he does it in the ring, it's a story, but like, I don't understand. Explain to me what is happening with this striking. Not jokingly, please try to make me seriously understand this.
He comes from a wrestling background.
Right.
He's a wrestler.
Got
it. And he just got his hip replaced.
Wrestlers aren't athletes, but striking is a different type of athleticism. Nate Robinson learned that real quick.
Yeah.
Granted, he's been doing it for some time now, but do we know how long he's been fighting professionally? I don't. So Jake's been boxing for 3 years now, like every day. Kid is super hungry. He wants it more than anything in his life. And I think a spoke might have been stuck in Ben's wheels after the Masvidal fight. Like, honestly, that was embarrassing. And Jake is going to chew on that bone during all the press conferences.
The only thing that was embarrassing about it was that it was Masvidal. You know what I'm saying? Like, if it was some unknown, bro, like, dude, a fucking...
Yeah, you got somebody that just...
In the ring
I'm going to say, dude, it sucked, but also at the same time, like, in fights, shit happens, bro. Like, you know this better than anyone in fights. Shit happens. You can't plan around it. And you surely cannot judge an entire man's career based on one flying knee to the face.
You can if
in no way.
The fight,
no
the
way.
Man swore that he was going to win and talked shit for ages about Masvidal, about his character, about his family, about his religion.
Question for you.
It's wild.
Do you know anybody else? In the
Conor McGregor done
yeah.
that.
Who talked endlessly about a man's character, their performance, their capability.
Yeah, Conor McGregor. To,
Not in 6 seconds.
Well, I'm just saying, it's happening.
Talking about me?
Yeah.
I lost, right?
Conor with Khabib.
I love you, but I'm just saying, like, that's part of the showmanship, and then sometimes it just doesn't
well,
go the way.
Back it up a little bit.
Right.
I don't think anyone's like, oh, you got your fucking ass kicked. I know, bro. It was a good fight. It was good showmanship.
Yeah.
Good sports.
Great
good
sports. Fight.
Great sports.
Quick maths. Great sport. Great but
quick maths.
So we know he has a chin. The big thing is a lot of people are saying that there's no shot that it will end in knockout for a Jake Paul. Not no shot, but definitely less
it will.
He's been punched many
most likely.
And has not gone down.
Third round.
To that type of
fourth
action.
Round.
The question I think for this fight comes down to stamina. Ben being a professional Olympic athlete definitely has a pretty large stamina.
One would presume.
Step, oh, it, do you think?
One would presume.
And this is an eight rounder.
More than Jake's last six rounder.
Which was really a
quick match.
Two rounder. Just, you know what I'm saying? It's like
I don't think it's gonna last 8 rounds.
It might. Ben's got an iron ass chin.
Ooh, I'm gonna call round three. We should all call around.
Yeah, but round three on what?
I say a knockout. I don't know who, Jake. I don't know who.
I just don't. My question, once again, back to you, and I really just need to understand this is how does Ben have a chance with those punches? I'm sorry. Like, can you explain to me why it looks like that? Like.
Could you show us something?
Yeah, just put. Can you pull up a video of any sort to show?
Is that Instagram?
Just because, like, okay, so back when I used to babysit and caretake my grandfather, he was 90. This is not talking shit about Ben.
I
maybe
hope you don't
is.
Ever bump into him.
No, I'm not. Because listen to me.
What do you mean, bro? Mike bumps into Ben Askren and he falls to the ground. He's tiny. He's a little guy.
Oh, how tall is he?
He's 5'11", I believe.
No chance.
Yeah, he is. I think he's 5'10 or 5'11. And Jake's 6'1.
He's 5'11?
Yeah. What is he? Look so small. I don't know, but.
What?
Like,
it's the hair.
Just pull up the punching because I just want to understand it. Like, I don't fucking.
No, that's not his real punch.
No, that. That can't be right. He can't do that in a fight. I mean, he could. But Jake's gonna be.
Here's him pulling
Jake's just gonna throw him around.
Nah, maybe not that one either. There's definitely one of him like sparring or just like messing around throwing combos. And it's just, you know, there's some Dogecoin chunks.
Yeah, we'll
I don't
see.
Know.
We'll see.
Whatever. I thought someone, and obviously, once again, back to it, Olympic, contender, world or championship wrestler, like the dude has the background of fighting. And so I want to say this also in closing up from my end. I gave Jake a ton of shit on all three fighters, on Deji, Gibb, and who was the last one? Nate Robinson, the slam dunk champion. In all honesty, no matter how he punches, no matter how he strikes, Jake Paul knocks this dude out. I do not come back that following Monday and talk shit about the fight. I can't do it. I really can't do it.
Well, you can. He's a wrestler.
No,
he's not really a boxer, is he?
Is, or if he's old or out of the sport or took a flying knee to the face, this dude's a fucking fighter. A literal fighter that has taken shots to the head round after round and kept fucking trucking. We saw him get pile drive to China, and get back up and choke the dude out. If Jake Paul knocks this dude out, I will no longer be able to say anything detracting from Jake Paul as a boxer.
It's a big fight. Good for Jake for taking it.
I like his hair.
Resilience. Okay, guys. That is it for this one. Logan Paul predicts Jake Paul versus Ben Askren, but he did not predict. Logan did not predict. George did, and Mike says he doesn't know yet. He's not sure. that'll be it. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification.